Hey guys, it's Coop, and this is the Movie Maker set from Grip Gear. This is a slider and pan head all in one, and it's targeted towards the beginner and goes for around $100. So is this really a complete movie making kit for $100? Let's find out. Starting off as usual with build quality, the slider rails are made of metal with the rest of it basically being made out of plastic. With that being said, the plastic feels sturdy and strong and overall pretty premium. All of the feet are adjustable and allow you to get some interesting shots. Along with that, there is a 1/4 inch mount inside of each of these feet that you can use to attach to a tripod. Moving right along to function, we're going to start with the slider, and there's actually two different ways you can use this. The first is using it manually. How you do this is by pulling out that blue clover pin, which will disengage the gear from the track, and you can just slide it around however you want. But the main selling point about this slider is that automatic functionality. To get the motor up and running, you need to turn on the switch to the high or low setting on the bottom of the motor, and then you can start using the controls on top. There's a plus and minus button for power input, and then you have left and right arrows basically determining what way you want the slider to slide. The controls are super easy and simple to use, and they're the exact same as what's on the included remote. If you are using the motor, you do need to worry about weight. Grip Gear says that it can move a max of 550 grams along a horizontal plane. With that being said, it worked with my G7 just fine. I mean, the G7 is definitely a light camera and all, but with all the attachments I have on there, it weighed much over that, and the slider didn't struggle at all. With that being said, the little adjustable ball head definitely did struggle, and so I really wouldn't recommend this for DSLR use at all. But that really shouldn't be a surprise, because the obvious targeted audience here are people who use phones and GoPros and point-and-shoots or just light cameras to shoot. Speaking of phone users, Grip Gear does include a high-quality and adjustable phone mount in the box. The actual result quality here is pretty good. Left and right is completely consistent thanks to the motor, but there are a few small bumps along the way. Most of those bumps are unnoticeable unless you look very closely, and is not a deal breaker at all, but it's still something to note. Just like the setup process, the transformation process to make this into a video head is extremely simple. Start by unscrewing one of the screws on the middle set of feet, and then pull off one side of the track. From there, once again, pull out that blue clover pin, and that will allow the motor to slide right off the track. Then just take this weird looking thing and snap it onto the side with that clover piece, and there you go, you've got a video head. The way this works is that that clover pin spins something inside of that little head, and it's geared way up so that the top piece spins very slowly. At the max speed of 8, it can work pretty well for getting normal pans and different product shots. But at lower speeds, the really special thing about this is it's perfect for time lapses. Here you can see a time lapse I filmed with this video head, and it turned out much better than I thought. So that's basically my review. It's a very simplistic product, but when you combine the fact that you get a pan head and slider, and you can technically use them both at the same time, not to mention they're both motorized, the possibilities are endless. So thank you guys so much for watching, and if you did enjoy, make sure to let me know by leaving a like and subscribing for more content. I'd also like to give a big thanks to Grip Gear for making this video possible and giving me this awesome slider for review. You'll probably see it in many upcoming videos like vlogs, where I just can't take my normal big slider. Speaking of which, that normal big slider actually goes for $100 as well. It's not motorized, but doesn't have a weight limit, and I made a review on it. It's worth checking out and comparing. Once again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.